Hello YouTube. Now I just bought a very nice mouse. This is a Logitech G500. And more importantly, it has three buttons that are non-standard and it has the scroll wheel. So let's first start with the scroll wheel. We open our exorg.conf and using exev to find which button presses these are actually creating. We add these buttons to the Z-axis mapping option on my input device. Ta-da, horizontal scroll works, but that's not enough. We've got three more buttons that aren't standard on mice. So first, let's look at them in XEV. Now, this one side button works fine, but these two don't generate any X events, and that's a problem. Now, the reason they don't is because they're programmed by the mouse to change its own DPI settings. Now I will admit I was lazy, I tried to do it in a virtual machine but it didn't work. So I downloaded the wonderful little G500 control program by Vladislav Shtabovenko. I hope I pronounced that right. Anyway, this little program flashes your mouse with the correct information that you want. So what I did with it is I lowered my DPI because I was used to having a DPI of 1000 instead of, you know, 5600. And I disabled the DPI buttons, which means that they are now sending out X events and can be keybinded. Now for keybinding, you've almost certainly heard of X bind keys. Unfortunately, X bind keys doesn't really cut it for a lot of games, especially in Wine, Guild Wars 2, Dishonored, etc. Just don't work with X bind key. So what we're going to do is we're going to go lower. Enter evrouter. Evrouter runs below exorg and sends input directly to exorg as opposed to running on exorg. Now it's very easy to run. You run it on your dev input event files with the dump flag. Then it runs basically the same as XEV. You catch the button presses, and it will automatically give you these lines at the bottom of each button press that you can paste into a configuration file. Now we're going to be changing two things on each line. First off, none. We're going to change that to any. This is the modifier. As it is, the buttons will work without any modifiers. That's good, unless you hold control, and then the buttons won't work. So what we're going to do is we're going to say any, so it will now work with any button press, and then we can use it to keybind, for instance, control button press in a game. Now next we have the key that we want, and I just used 0, 9, and 8 because they're keybindable by most modern PC games, but because they're also far enough away from my WASD hand that I'm unlikely to ever use them. The problem with this is that it needs to run as root, so if you want to run it as sudo and type in your password every time you log in, that's fine, but yeah, don't want to do that, do you? So we're going to use the login manager. Now you've heard of GDM, KDM, and LightDM, and I'm going to use LightDM because I'm on XFCE, but it's also used by standard Ubuntu. So what we're going to do is we're going to open a config file at /lightdm/lightdm.conf, and we're going to add the option session startup script, and we're going to direct that to a file we have stored in opt. And in this file, we simply run evrouter with the C flag to direct it to the config file that we saved earlier. So now whenever you log in through LightDM, it'll run that script, which will run evrouter using those settings. So just restart your computer to restart LightDM properly. And then when you log in, your mouse buttons should work fine.